Machano, today we're gonna make my version of the Vizcayan style cut, so let me give you the ingredients. So for this occasion, I'm gonna use the Pacific cut. I have two fillets. I'm just gonna use, you know, one for this recipe. You can use as many pieces as you need. And as you can see, this is fresh one. So it's different from the salty one, or the preserved one. Then we're gonna need our main ingredients. So garlic, it's gonna be about tablespoon or so. Capers, 2 tablespoons. Make sure that these ones there are rinsed and washed with cold water, so that way you remove the excess of salt. 1/4 of an onion, you can use any kind of onion. It's gonna be up to you which one you wanna use, white, Spanish, purple. Some 1 tomato, Roma tomato, dice it up. You can always substitute the tomato for the canned tomato, or the tomato paste, or the tomato sauce. If you're making your tomato sauce, you know, you can do it from scratch also. And also, I'm gonna need some green olives, black olives, almonds, and pepperoncinis. You can always substitute the olives for the ones that you prefer. You can use the one that is tough. You know, it's gonna be up to you with the pirane, or however you wanna use it, it's gonna be up to you. I'm gonna use 1 cup of white wine, your choice. 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Some black pepper. And on the salt, we have to be really, really careful, because this dish is really, you know, all the ingredients are salty. So the olives, the capers, and if you're using the dehydrated cut, it's gonna be salty. So that's why a lot of people, they don't like to make this dish, because it's very salty when it's dry. So that's why I prefer to use this one that is fresh, and you can always make it, you know, with fresh cut. And also I'm gonna need some of flour for this dish, because we're making fresh. So I'm just gonna flour it and then pan sear it. But if you're using the dry one, then don't use the flour, right? So that should be it. Oh, the potatoes. And also I have about 6-7 potatoes of each, the red potatoes and new potatoes. So I got them already boiled. So I got a movie here. You can leave the skin on or peel them. However you want to use them is fine. So I'm gonna give you the next step and show you the next procedure. So for our fillet, I'm just gonna add some salt and pepper to taste. It's gonna be optional how much salt you wanna put it, remember. We got salt ingredients, so just go easy on the salt. You can always add more at the end. So now, we're gonna put our saute pan to heat them up. And like I say, this one, if you're making fresh, you just slightly flour it. But if you're using the other one, then just leave it like that, no salt. I mean, no flour. So just like that. Lightly dust it, and then I'm gonna have my pan already hot, and we're gonna put some oil. So I'm gonna put about 1 tablespoon of oil. Potatoes are done. So just make sure your pan it's hot. I'm gonna let it warm up a little bit longer, and then come back and show you the next step. All right, so after you have your fish already dusted with flour, we're gonna have our pan already hot, some oil, and we're gonna sear it first. I'm gonna do the tail, since this one is gonna take less. And we're gonna lightly sear it for about 3 minutes. Don't move it, just leave it like that, let it, you know, cook. And then we're gonna come back and add the rest of the cream. Also, I'm gonna add about 2 tablespoons of butter, so that way I can have my fish nice and golden brown. And that's gonna help us to keep a nice color on the fish also. So flip it over. And then we're gonna return and start making our sauce. So also I'm gonna do a little basting with fresh thyme.
So what I did, you know, with my butter and oil, as you can see, it's a little raw in the middle right here. So I'm gonna put a fresh thyme and toast them a little bit. And this one is gonna help to give me more flavor to my fish. And also I'm gonna use this for my garnish. And so I'm gonna use it with my potatoes. That's gonna be part of my garnish. So now, we're gonna remove this one carefully. Because this one is a flaky fish, so you don't want it to break. So we're just gonna put it there. Same thing with this one. So this is my rest, my whole fillet right here. This is how it looks when it's the whole fillet. So now, we're gonna have this one resting. And we're gonna start our sauce. So I'm gonna add onion first. Get some flavor out. And then I'm gonna come back and show you the next step. So then you're gonna add your garlic. Get some caramelization also on the garlic. It's gonna be about 1 minute. And then when you have the golden brown, we're gonna add the capers. Same thing. Just a quick saute so that way we can stop some of the heat from the pan. So that way we don't burn our garlic. So about 1 minute. And then we're gonna add the tomatoes. I'm gonna do a little bit and then come back and add the rest of the tomatoes. So remember that I told you that we can use either the fresh tomato or the canned tomato. You can do both versions. If you want to do more like rustic sauce, then you go and do your sofrito here. And if you like more chunky, you know, you can do it like this, or you can do half and half. You can do your tomato sauce, tomato paste, and the fresh tomatoes. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna deglaze with the white wine, and then I'm gonna add some of this tomato sauce, and we're gonna come back and start making a side dish. See, you see the tomato? Now you're gonna add the wine. You're gonna do about a quarter of a cup. Let it reduce, so bring it to boil, and then let it reduce. So this sauce is done, basically. You can just finish it with some olive oil or butter. But I'm gonna let my wine reduce by half, and then I'm gonna add some of this sauce in here. After you have your wine reduced, then you're gonna add the olives, the almonds, pepperoncini, and also the chile de árbol or chili flakes. This is gonna be optional, okay? And then add our tomato sauce. Like that. So you can finish this sauce with some olive oil or butter. Basically, this sauce is done. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use some butter. And if you want to add some parsley or basil, it's gonna be optional. So but usually goes with the parsley at the end, just to finish the plate. And then the butter is gonna help me to do my sauce a little bit richer. So this is done, you can put your fish back in here, or you can use the sauce like, you know, on the top, on the bottom. However you want to plate it, it's gonna be optional. So I'm gonna, or you can return the fish here and then let it break in here. However you want to do it, it's gonna be up to you. So we're gonna do our spinach. I'm gonna use some sauteed spinach and my potatoes for my garnish, okay? So, for my potatoes, I have 1 tablespoon of fresh herbs, rosemary, thyme, and sage, and some garlic. So usually goes with the potatoes. The potatoes goes in here. So you can do your potatoes here or on the side. So just add some potatoes. And I'm gonna leave some to make them on the side. And this dish is done. So just one more potato. So this one is done. But I'm gonna also add some spinach on for my garnish. But this is the sauce that goes with the fish, a la Biscayne. Then you can put your fish back in here and it's done. So let's go and get some spinach and start making my side dish. Right, so this sauce is done, like I say. You know, you put your potatoes, you can serve it like this. But also I'm gonna add some of spinach, so that way it's gonna be part of my garnish. So that one is gonna be a bunch of spinach, 1 to 2 anchovy fillets in oil with a little chili flakes, red onion, half an onion, some garlic, and 2 ounces of wine, and salt pepper to taste. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add some of my anchovy oil, and then we're gonna get our onions first. And also I'm gonna add 2 anchovy fillets. This is gonna help me get my spinach nice and flaky. 2 anchovy fillets. Get my onion caramelized. Give my quick sauté and come back. And then we're gonna add some of the garlic. So as you can see, the anchovy, it disappears. So get the garlic going, golden brown. And then we're gonna add the spinach. So that way, it can start welding. No salt because we got the anchovies. So just add black pepper. Let it sweat and come back. Now we're gonna add the spinach. And gonna let them work. Then just add some black pepper. No salt because we got the anchovy fillet. But it's gonna be optional if you wanna add more. And then the rest of our wine that we had from the 1 cup, it's gonna be about 2 ounces left. So we're gonna deglaze it. Let the wine evaporate and then we're gonna finish our meat. Like I said, for the plating, you can plate it however you want. You know, I'm gonna just use the basic spinach on the bottom. You can put the sauce on top. You can do the sauce on the bottom, spinach on top, up to you. However you wanna plate it, it's gonna be optional. So hopefully you guys like this video on how to prepare the cod, my version of Fiorentine style. And also, this recipe has a lot of versions on how to prepare this dish. You know, a lot of people do it different ways. So it's hard when you have a classic recipe that you want to redo. Some people, they're gonna say, oh, no, it doesn't go like this. It doesn't go that way. You know, that's not the way you're supposed to do it. So that's why I say it's gonna be my version, and you can make it however you want. You can substitute it, you know, do anything you want. So also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Chef Alex Perez on Facebook, Chef Alex Perez in YouTube, Chef Alex Perez 34 in Instagram. And hopefully you guys like this video, enjoy it, and as you can see, it's different, you know, from the other ones. But it's gonna be up to you if you wanted to marry my version. Really good. Thank you, enjoy.